despite increased focus on national and regional emission reduction targets. By 2030 or 2050, fossil fuels are still a major part of the global energy production. And with new methods becoming cheaper and more advanced and more expensive extraction becoming profitable during periods of high oil prices, we might not yet have seen the peak in global production. In 2019, the world produced 4,500 million tons of crude oil, or 95 million barrels a day. In this video, we will take a look at what nations are producing and visualize it on a world map. In North America, Canada and the US have ramped up their production, coming close to doubling their numbers in just the last 15 years. Every marker in this video represents 1 million tons of crude oil production. Alongside a decline in coal and a rapid increase in natural gas, the US is now a net producer of crude oil and is now a major exporter globally. Since the oil fields of Pennsylvania was exploited in the 1950s, oil production has been an important part of the US economy, and today Texas, the Gulf of Mexico and North Dakota are the main extracting areas. In Mexico, the production peaked around 2005 and is in decline since then. Venezuela used to be one of the major producers of petroleum and is a founding member of OPEC. But due to policy changes under Hugo Chavez, which nationalized much of the oil production, and general unrest in the country in recent years, the industry has crashed. Instead, Brazil is now the major producer in South America, with over 150 million tons in 2019. In Europe, the production peaked in the late 1990s, and while Norway and the United Kingdom is still the main producers on the continent, both are producing significantly less today. On the African continent, the production has gone down slightly in recent years, despite an expanding economy in many nations. Nigeria, followed by Angola, Algeria and Libya are the main producers. Russia was the second largest producer in 2019, continually ramping up its production since the dip during the economic transition in the 1990s. Today, Russia is close to the peak levels of the Soviet Union in the 1980s. Kazakhstan is the second largest producer in the former USSR. China is the only major producer of petroleum in Asia outside Russia and the Middle East, with close to 200 million tons in 2019. Most nations in Southeast Asia and Australia have seen a slight decrease in production during the last couple of decades. And finally, while not as dominant as they used to be, the Gulf states produce a sizable share of the world's oil yearly. Saudi Arabia, the third largest producer in the world currently, has been rather stable since the 1990s and are mainly joined by Iraq, Iran, Kuwait, Qatar and the UAE in the region. Oil and fossil fuels are no doubt on the decline in the long run. In a time where global emission targets are set, the prices of new renewable energy sources are falling, and when cars and other transportations stride towards electrification. But on the other hand, the population is still growing, and energy demands are as high as they have ever been. And there are no real indications that we will in any serious way risk of running out of oil. At least not as long as oil prices remain high and stable. Many nations in the world are investing less in fossil fuel extractions today, but when prices are good, more expensive reserves become profitable for investment. We will also most likely see investments in more environmentally risky areas, not the least in the ever-melting Arctic, where large reserves are likely to hide. The transition away from fossil fuels will be most impactful for the nations where a large share of the economy is dependent on high prices. But it is certainly not only undemocratic, elite-run Gulf states that will feel the change. In many democratic nations, inhabitants working in these industries have a large influence on the debate and the general public. While the debate in the US largely has focused on coal, the ever-expanding oil and gas extraction could be next in line in risk of declining demand, and plans and support has to be in place for those communities when it happens. Thank you for watching this video on the oil extraction of the world. I have other videos on energy production you might find interesting. You can check them out. Feel free to subscribe if you want to see what new videos I have planned for the future. And if you have suggestions for topic you want me to cover, you can write them in the comments down below.